Let's walk through the Forney EasyWeld 100ST. This is a stick and TIG welder. Stick welding is a welding process that uses a consumable electrode to lay a bead. TIG, or tungsten inert gas welding, uses a tungsten electrode and an inert gas like argon. It's often thought of as the more difficult process to learn due to increased hand-eye coordination. In one hand, you have your TIG torch, in the other, you're using a filler metal to lay a bead. However, you don't always have to use a filler metal, as it's optional. This machine runs off of 120 volt input and produces 90 amps output. This machine comes with a ground clamp, electrode holder, and the TIG torch is sold separately. You want to make sure the ground clamp is attached to a metal workbench or the actual metal you'll be working with. To do TIG welding, you need to use an inert shielding gas like 100% argon. You will need to use a Type 9 torch with a 25 DINS connector and a valve on the torch. These do not come with the machine and can be purchased separately. For stick welding, it's very important to choose the right electrode. I recommend the Forney E6013 electrode. It's easy to strike and performs well on most steel applications. When you're ready to weld, use the process selector switch to select between TIG or stick welding. Use the amperage dial to select your amperage based on the recommended settings for the material thickness you're using. And remember, this machine can weld between 16 gauge up to 5/16 inch. When welding, you want to get into a very comfortable body position. Lean over the piece, brace your arm, and control the movement of the electrode very carefully. Don't hold it in the air so it wobbles. You want to support your weight and be in control. Remember to control the travel speed as well. Think of this like controlling the speed when you're driving. Next, pay attention to the stick out. The stick out is the distance between the metal and the end of your electrode. This is similar to controlling the following distance from the car in front of you. Lastly, focus on the path. You want a nice and consistent weld, similar to staying in the lane when you're driving. Welding takes practice. If you're in control and monitor all of your variables, it becomes second nature. Let's show you some examples of some test welds. Traveling too fast looks like this. Too slow looks like this. Amperage setting too high looks like this. Don't forget to clean your weld with a slag hammer and a wire brush. That sums up our Forney EasyWeld 100ST. It's a powerful little machine that gets the job done for all of your stick and TIG welding needs. It's great for hobbyists, DIY, and maintenance and repair, and it comes with a 6-month warranty.
Hello, this is Scott from Lodos Technologies, and I'm here to introduce you to one of our best sellers, the Lodos TIG 200. This machine functions as a 200 amp AC-DC TIG and stick welder. It's capable of welding aluminum, stainless steel, mild steel, and other metals. The foot pedal gives you versatility and maneuverability. This machine is perfect for the home enthusiast to get industrial results. Now I'm here to show you how to set it up, and we'll run some tests. today. Thanks for watching.
Hey guys, Scott here in the Eastwood Garage to talk about our TIG 200 DC welder, which can easily weld steel and stainless steel up to a quarter inch thick. This versatile machine has a small footprint and lightweight design, making it perfect for portability. Buying a TIG welder can be a daunting task for anyone new to welding, as many units have so many options your head will spin. We purpose-built the TIG 200 DC to get great welds with minimal investment or welding knowledge, which makes it perfect for the beginner. Pre and post flow for the shielding gas are pre-programmed into the machine, leaving only amperage to worry about. Amperage is adjustable from 10 to 200 amps, which means you can easily weld sheet metal up to quarter inch plate. This amperage can be controlled one of two ways. A finger control on the torch allows for the user to set the amperage at the machine and weld in areas in which you cannot actuate the foot pedal. The foot pedal allows for varied amperage during welding, up to a user-defined maximum, for the most precise welding possible. You don't even have to get up and walk back to the unit if amperages need to be adjusted, as our foot pedal functions as a remote control with an amperage control knob. A perfect example would be if you only need 100 amps to weld a project. Simply set the knob on the foot pedal and enjoy varied amperage from 10 amps up to 100 amps. Our MOSFET inverter ensures precise and clean high-frequency arc starts along with superior puddle and penetration control. Another great advantage to an inverter-based machine is its low weight, around 18 pounds for this unit. You can even have the ability to run plugged into 110 or 220 volt power, and we include an adapter to keep it simple from switching between inputs. Don't have power? Go right ahead and run on a generator for the job site welding. Just keep in mind that when plugged into 110 volt power, you'll be slightly limited to welding amperage of about 140, as you simply don't have the power going into the machine. Even at 110 volt, this machine can still lay down beads and metals up to 1/8 inch thick. That's nothing to sneeze at. We've even added stick welding capability to this unit, making it even more valuable around the property or job site. Now you don't even have to carry shielding gas around when making those welds outside, as stick welding has been an industry standard for years. Just throw our electrode holder in your shopping cart when you purchase this if you plan on stick welding with this machine. The industry standard WP17 torch we include means you'll be able to source replacement consumables without any troubles, keeping you welding for years to come.
Spark your imagination with the EasyTIG 165i TIG welder. Weighs only 50 pounds, so it's easy to take anywhere. Just plug it into 230 volt power, connect the gas, select the material and thickness, and you're ready to weld. The EasyTIG 165i offers a unique single knob control, making it quick and easy to use. High frequency start allows for non-contact arc starting that eliminates tungsten and material contamination. Up to 165 amps of power in both AC and DC modes. Spark your imagination.
In purchasing a TIG welder. Now, TIG welding is going to give you a cleaner bead, it's more aesthetically pleasing, you're going to be able to work better on thinner materials, and you're also going to be able to control all three of your elements in process. Now, things to consider when you're talking about purchasing your first TIG welder, number one is power. Let's talk about that, 120 or 240. It's going to really depend on what you're working on and what space is available to you. If you're in a small shed, you want a smaller unit that doesn't take up a larger footprint that probably only has 120. So these are some things to consider as well. Now, the next thing, what material thickness are you going to be welding on most? That is going to tell you what amperage you need. And last but not least is budget. What do you actually need in relationship to what you're going to be doing? Some Miller TIG models offer expanded feature sets such as AC pulse control, balance, and features that will help you control the puddle moving through your weld. Let's review two of the more popular models from the Miller TIG line. So this is the Diversion 180. This is the unit that we actually use to teach people how to TIG weld here at Arc Academy. And the reason we love it here is because this is straight up just a TIG welder, and it's very simple. You have AC-DC control by a push of a button. Your amperage control is on a knob right here, and it does have the MVP plug where we can plug it into 120 or 240, and it can go pretty much anywhere in our shop. It's a fantastic little machine, and I love teaching people on this. But if you are looking for those expanded feature sets that we were just talking about, you may want to look into the SecretWave 210. It does have the ability for stick welding and also has a lot more features to control the puddle moving through your TIG weld. The SecretWave 210 also features an expanded duty cycle, a higher quality torch, an industrial foot pedal, and running gear. And finally, the 210 also features an SD port, which allows you to upgrade your unit. So what do these two units have in common? They both share the 120 volt and 240 volt power supply. Both are inverter based, so they're lightweight and portable. Both have an outstanding weld arc and are also covered by the TrueBlue 3-year warranty. If you don't plan on doing a lot of aluminum TIG, another thing to consider is a multi-process machine, such as the Multimatic 215. The Multimatic 215 will allow you DC, TIG, stick, and MIG. For more information on Miller...